Welcome to the Bureau of Meteorology's National Water Account, providing you with an annual picture of water availability around the country. We look at 10 key regions, representing most of Australia's population and more than 80% of Australia's water use, analysing data from 1st of July 2015 to 30th of June 2016. During that time, Australia's climate was influenced by a strong El Niño, which contributed to relatively dry conditions across the country for most of the year. In northern Australia, rainfall was well below average during January to March, which is typically the wettest part of the year. In the Ord region, the normal filling of Lake Argyll didn't occur, and the storage volume dropped by almost 20% during the year. In the Daly region, which relies heavily on groundwater, aquifer water stores were not replenished and dropped for the fourth consecutive year. In 2012, the Murray-Darling Basin storage volumes were near capacity, but have been steadily dropping since. By 2015, they are at 42% and continued to fall to 39% by 2016. Storage volumes in the urban centres also look like being well below previous year's levels. However, heavy rainfall associated with East Coast lows in May and June helped storage volumes recover, especially along the East Coast. National water use dropped by 8% compared to the previous year, mainly due to a decrease in water use in the Murray-Darling Basin. This reflects the low water availability and drier conditions across the region, and continues a trend of reduced water use over the past few years. Around three quarters of Australia's water supply was for commercial and private users, mainly related to agriculture. 18% of the country's water was for town supply, and 10% was used to support the health of rivers, wetlands and floodplains. Surface water was the largest source of water across Australia, making up 78% of all water used. However, in our capital cities, the drop in surface water availability meant the use of alternative water sources, such as inter-region transfers and desalinated water, increased during the year. In Adelaide and Melbourne, half the water supply was sourced from inter-region deliveries, while Perth's desalination plants operated near capacity and provided around 20% of the region's water supply. In summary, a fourth consecutive year of dry conditions across much of Australia meant storage volumes continued to decrease around the country, and water use decreased in line with the reduced water availability. You can find more details on each of the 10 regions on our website at bom.gov.au/water/NWA.